It's May 14th, and this is a garden update. Where to begin? It's just, everything looks great. We've got our strawberry towers. Making strawberries, and I did the self-watering system, and it seems to be working great. I don't see anything dry. We do need to get a rebar and stake these because we had to tie them to the fence because they were toppling. My Thai basil is huge. Onions, I think, probably can harvest in the next week. Arugula is starting to bolt, so we need to go ahead and harvest. Lettuce is doing great. We've been eating lots of salads. Lots of salads. These are my San Marzanos. This is my melon, and it's all fruited up. I mean, not fruited up. Flowers everywhere for fruit. This is a weed, I believe. I need to come back and get that, but yeah, these are definitely weeds. Pepper here. These tomatoes have flowers everywhere. My zinnias are beautiful. The tomatoes are doing great. We need to address this situation here because I had it on a little tiny stake. You can see right here, which clearly is not strong enough to hold up the tomato plant. So these ones are doing a little bit better in the cages. And let's see, pepper bed. Everything looks beautiful. I put my peppers in tomato cages just to keep them from toppling when they get heavy. I'm leaving some weeds because this weed is getting eaten up by something, but my peppers aren't. So I'm using that weed as a decoy. And then I've got my cucumbers climbing up just as we had hoped they would. We did have to kind of pull them in a little bit at the bottom with some tape because they were starting to sprawl into the beds. But well, I think we have it under control now, and they seem to be going up. So those are cucumbers. And let's see over here. The tomatoes are just, oh, we got tomatoes everywhere. You can just see from the top of the cages about how tall these San Marzanos are. These tomatoes, I planted from seed. They were supposed to be little cherry chocolate tomatoes called chocolate sprinkles, and they are not. They are some other kind of tomato that snuck into my garden. So we'll see how those turn out. I'm a little sad that I'm not going to have my chocolate sprinkles, but I'm curious about these guys. So anyway, here is my archway. Tomatoes, some are taller than others. You can see all my San Marzanos. Look at this. They are just coming everywhere. You can see, look at these guys. Look at this. I mean, we are gonna be some cannon fools. Look at the size of these. They're everywhere. So let's see. Fruit trees are doing great in the wicking tubs. Here's another view of my tomatoes. And then for the final bed over here, this is the climbing zucchini. It's climbing. The Malabar spinach is just, it's heated up here in Texas. We're in the 90s now, and I think that's what the spinach loves because all of a sudden it's just started grabbing on. This one's a little dry, not sure why, because it's getting water. But look at the size of this zucchini plant. Flowers everywhere. Look how beautiful. One thing I just learned out of a cookbook is that chefs will pull these flowers and use them to wrap different things and serve them as appetizers. It's supposed to be really tasty. If you're having an over explosion of zucchinis, that's what, one way to temper them back a little bit. I'm not going to though. We've got yellow squash, and then these are lima beans over here. These are regular beans, and look at the asparagus beans going up this arch. That just makes my heart sing. That's exactly what I was hoping for. Look, so pretty. Love it. Can't wait for it to meet at the top. So there we have it. Everything's healthy. Not seeing any signs of disease. It's just starting to get hot, so I think this is when things start to sometimes change in our garden, where we have to get a little bit more involved. I did put ladybugs and praying mantises out, so hopefully we can continue to be organic and not have to use any pesticides. There's my husband in the background pulling weeds. Okay. Say hi.
Hi.
If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Thank you. Bye.